Your tune is flat and all the words are wrong. Please tell me why you never acted like this. You never turned away.
Well, here we is again, boys. You've seen this view before. Of course, there's the mighty Crown Vic, minus its paint on the roof. And I'll give you a guess of what day it is. Nope, it's not your birthday. It's not Judgment Day. At least the day, well, the day's young still, so who knows. Right, get your shit in order, because Judgment Day is coming. But today, you know the drill. Yep, that's what we're doing. Range test. See, I'm trying to see where I'm... Yep, range test today. 100 yards. And I'm going to title this one... Well, this is a new K31. I just got done putting together. And, looks like it came out pretty nice out in the sun here. First time I've had it out in the sun, which was really revealing about how it all turned out. It looks pretty darn good, I think. And so it's, just take a look at it here. I'm gonna take my first shots with it today. Like I say, just got done putting it together. But I am going to title today's range test video Out in the Weeds, because I have got so many variables going on today that who knows how this is going to turn out. So any inconsistencies I wouldn't attribute to anything but me, and I can't throw too many variables in the mix, you know, to confuse, get things confused, right? But so anyways, first off, on my rear diopter, I've taken and I've removed the optical section of it that has the offset lenses in there for people with astigmatisms. I think it was in my case, I think it was hindering my view of the target, so I removed it. So I've just screwed the adjustable iris, the color filter, and the magnification and focus sections together on it, and with removed the optical section out of it. I can see the target. It looks like I can see the target better without it, so I'm going to try that today. And I have taken, and because of that, I've taken and I've changed my front post to a very thin front post. We're going to give a front post, thin front post, to try instead of a wide, flat post. See how that pans out. And then, as you can see, I've set up my chronograph. I'm going to try to see if I can get some velocity readings over a few different kinds of loads I have today, just real quickly. It's about 50 degrees out. No, not even 50. I'd say it's more like maybe 45 degrees, maybe a little less even. I've got some 200 grain Sierra Match Kings on top of 49 grains of 4000 MR. Some 150 grain Full Metal Jackets Hornady on top of 48 grains of IMR 4064. Have a little bit of GP11 ammunition. I've run GP11 over the chronograph previously, but it was on a hotter day. It's cooler out. I'm curious, just kind of curious. Then I've got some 178 grain ELD match bullets on top of 46 grains of IMR 4320. That round I know shoots well. And I'm going to throw into the mix here 178 grain Hornady ELD X rounds, which are classified a hunting round, but they show a higher ballistic coefficient than the match rounds. And so, same load, IMR 4320, 46 grains of it. All this stuff is loaded into GP11 brass. And so I'm just kind of curious to see if I can differentiate between the X or the match bullets, see if there's any difference in them in anything, accuracy or velocity or anything. Higher ballistic coefficient. I'm trying to find the higher ballistic coefficient of bullet as I can, as close to a 174 grain GP11 bullet. So I'm trying to make a GP11 clone, but that'll be the another one of my variables I'm going to try today. And so let's see. Well, nobody's here. Let me turn this thing around. We'll get a look at the other side of it. And of course, here's the other side of it. As you can see, and any of you guys that know my work, you realize that my work is true to form. They're not perfect. Some of the imperfections from these things having been fielded remain. I'm not trying to sanitize the stocks or remove their heritage or any of that stuff. But all in all, this one came out really clean. It did. If you look, see that? That's a perfect parting line right there. You almost can't even see where the handguard and the stock meet. Nice true edges, nice true finger mortises around the sling cutout, nice square edges there. As you can see, the butt plate fits like a glove. I believe this to be an original as-built rifle. I think it was issued one time from my observations of what I see on it. I think it was issued one time. It's all correct, dated correctly for that. I think this rifle was never rebuilt. I think this is as it was out of the factory, out of the arsenal. The throat on this thing checks a spectacular 2.0, which is basically like new. So this rifle's been shot, but not much. So anyways, let me get my shit put together here and see if I can't sling a few rounds downrange. Boys, put my sights on it, my adopters, did a little bore sight on it. Hopefully it'll be reasonably close. I guess we will find out here shortly. And I got my chronograph set up, so let's see where this first shot will go. See where this first shot will go. Now I'm going to use these are the 150 grain Hornady Full Metal Jacket, 48 grains of IMR 4064. I'm going to take my first shot with that. I've never shot this rifle before. It's the first time it's ever had a loaded round in it since I've had it. Of course, this is one of my restorations. If any of you are interested in it, depending on how the range test goes, contact me on my YouTube channel, and we'll see if we can't get one of these fine K31s into your hands. All right, here we go. Scooch it over a little bit. There we go. Back over. Gotta be careful. You don't want to shoot your chronograph. That wouldn't be good. Looks good. Felt pretty good. 2758 on that. And I'm going to check headspace on this. And we are looking at 1 inch 805. It's good. That is good. That is right in the range. I like it. Okay. Can't remember how many times I've used this GP11 brass, but it looks okay so far. Let's take a look and see where it went. It's not too bad for a bore sight, huh? By eye, by old blind me. That's 11 o'clock on the 10 ring line. I'm gonna take another shot with it just the way it is. See where it goes. It's good. That's it's a good decent load. It's flattens the primers just a little bit. It's good. It's the velocity on it. 2791. Gotta remember, it's relatively cool out here today too. So on a hot day, I'm sure this. I think I've chronographed these rounds before in a hot day, and they were about over 2800, 2825, somewhere in there. So where I'm seeing now, yeah, it wouldn't shock me. Well, gonna have to get used to the elevation. The windage is exactly the same as my first shot. The elevation was quite a bit higher. Like I said, I'm working with a whole different setup on my sights that I'm trying to get in tune with. I can tell though, I can already tell, I can see the target better without that optical section in my rear diopter. Ah, man, coming up on the end of my my breath thing there. As a result, I feel like I may have pulled that a little bit left. However, it's not bad. That went basically right next to my very first shot. 2811. 2811 on that round. That's good. That is good. That thing's humming right along. Like I say, this is basically the same ballistics as a 30-06, but it has a felt recoil of like a 6.5 Swede. That's a beautiful thing about K31s. They're powerful, yet they're not overpowering. Okay, boys. Nice trigger on this. Nice trigger. I've checked it. It has the usual 32 ounce first stage, and it breaks 75, 80 ounce maybe. That's standard fare for military trigger on a K31. 2813. That one is right there too. That is pretty much right next to my last shot. Let's take this, one more. Be a 5-shot string. I get these sights figured out, I may just like them. My front sight blade is thin now. I made it thin. And what it does is it really shows me how much variable there is, because I can see the tiny movement of it underneath the shooting seat. Don't need my sweaty cheek all over the rifle. Oh, man. Let's take a look. 2793. That is spot on right there. I had that second shot getting used to my elevation. It went high. But the other four, nice. And that's my Plinkin ammunition. I think I'm gonna go down range, cover those targets up, and try a different bullet now. I know what these guys do. Good thing to know, right? Okay. Okay, guys, here's my first 5 shots ever out of that rifle. And my first one, I think, was here. Second one here, because like I said, I'm trying a whole new setup on my sight, so obviously I was trying to get used to it. But anyways, same windage though, perfect windage. But there was the other three right there. That's tight. That is pretty darn tight. Variables or not. Anyways, I was happy with that. That was with the 150 grain full metal jacket Hornady on top of 48 grains of IMR 4064. Looks like a pretty good load, huh? All right, I'm gonna cover these holes and try another load. Here we is. Let's try something a little different now. These are loads are 178 grain Hornady ELD, extreme low drag, they say. Match on top of 46 grains of IMR 4320. I have shot this load before, and I know it's accurate. Turn on our crony baloney. Okay. All right, let's try this one. Good. I have to say the reloaded GP11 brass works real well. 2587. We are 1.5 inches high and 2 inches to the left of absolute orange bullseye. So this one, if it stays there, I may make a sight adjustment on it. Okay, that one is high. A little bit left still. Give it some clickage to the right. I'm going to go down a little bit. See if I can't. That one came in at 2564. Which is probably about right. I think I was getting about 26, 25 on a hot day out of this load. That's a bullseye, boys. That's what I want to see. It's good. Well, that last shot was a bullseye. Had to do a little socializing with the range officer. Over here checking on me, making sure I'm above board. I usually am. Sometimes she grinds on me about my steel wire target I put down there. You're not supposed to have any steel down range. All right. 2590. That there, boys and girls, is what's called another bullseye. Like it. 2590 on the velocity, excellent accuracy. That's a good load right there. Of course, I knew it was. That was my pet load. Can't wait to try these X bullets with the higher ballistic coefficient. That's tight. That's a three-shot group right there. Of course, not counting my first two shots with this ammo. I did a little adjustment on the sights. That's three. I'm gonna take one more just to make sure. God, I'm pressing my luck here though. I know that. Damn. Gotta do it though. That one was 2595. That is just cracking right there. That is an accurate load. I like my new sight setup. Seems to work. And this rifle is seriously accurate. No doubt about it. Okay, guys. I'm going to go down range, cover those holes up, and try some of these X bullets. See where they go.
Well, there you go. That's six rounds, but that was my first one, my second one. I'm playing with the sights a little bit. Got it down to here, and then there's four rounds right there. That is stellar right there. That is absolutely dead nuts. I love it. I don't think I can shoot much better than that. Okay, I'm gonna cover these up, and I'm gonna try a different load.
Okay, guys, so far so good. And last set of shots I fired were on the button, man. Aren't K31s just freaking magical? They just are. You know, few things in this world work as advertised. This is one of them. All right, let's try. This is the same load, just a little different bullet is all. This is 46 grains of IMR 4320 underneath 178 grain Hornady ELDX. They're supposed to have a little bit higher ballistic coefficient, theoretically. And so, let's see where they go. Hope my eyes hold up. So far I'm doing pretty good. I think my new sight setup is definitely a plus. All right, I expect the same velocities. And 2590, same velocities. I do believe that is continuing to go through my previous group. Might be a little hard to tell where they're going. Okay. Let's take a look. We got 26-19. So far those are just going through my my first group that I made with 150 grainers. Interesting, huh? Yep, they're going through the same group as before. That's good. Makes it a little hard to tell which ones are which though. Okay, let's take a look. 2609. Wow, I am human. Pull that one a little to the right. Interesting, huh? All right. Six, 11. They're consistent. That's back through those, that same group with all the holes in it already. Okay. There we go. I think that one was a bullseye. Hard to see. I have to watch the. I was trying to hold a little bit off to where I thought it'd be a bullseye. But that's a pretty good load right there. I can tell that is equally as accurate as the match rounds. Except you can take down a moose with these too, Bowwinkle. That's good. Good consistent velocities too.
Well, here you go, guys. There's five shots. I had one get away from me just a little bit right there, but the rest of those are right there. That's through that group I shot earlier, and so I'm gonna have to watch the video, see if you can even tell what the order is or where they went, but they're going through the same group as before.
Okay, guys, I think it's time to see if I can't put a hurting on the steel post. See how my new sight setup works for it. Oh yeah, I think I like that. I think that was a hit. I do believe that was a hit. Hit again. Ringing a bell now. you go. Four or five shots on the steel post, all hits. I like it. As you can see, this K31 turned out spectacular. Let me know, guys, anybody is interested in acquiring this one, or I have a beechwood one that's extremely nice too. But this thing is on the money, deadly accurate, beautiful rifle. Okay, guys, I think that concludes my range test for the day.